isn't it? I'm Diana. I'll take you to your quarters.
Someone likes to keep secrets.
Secrets are our stock and trade. Besides, from what I hear, you have a few of your own. I'm not like you, in case you're wondering. I'm in the handler program. Agents and handlers work in unity. You know the expression, know your enemy? Well, that part is my job.
Knowing your enemy is only half the victory.
I know. You also need to know yourself. I'm working on it. I read your case file. Impressive work. Partly textbook, but I suppose field work never is. Tell me, what did it feel like, taking lives?
Random. Disordered.
Is that why you came here? Why you let us test you?
Maybe I'm not the only one being tested.
Well, we are here. Basic training starts at 0600 hours. I should leave you to prepare.
Are you sure about this?
I am.
There are no second chances, Miss Burnwood. Not here.
I choose him.
May I inquire why? A blank slate? Antisocial? Apathetic and unresponsive? No doubt the boy shows promise, but...
Perhaps I see possibility where others see limitation. Isn't that what a handler does, sir?
We'll see. Anyone can kill Miss Burnwood. He still remembers nothing?
If he does, he's not sharing.
We will check up on his story. The hospital in Romania. In the meantime, keep him under close watch. How did you know?
I told you he had talent.
His stats are off the charts. Such skills and reflexes. They could only be the result of previous training. Power like that, with no moral restraint. He could be dangerous.
I thought that was rather the point, sir.
All agents have weak spots, Miss Burnwood. Pressure points to keep them in check. But this one... Perhaps it would be better to just...
Give me a chance, sir. Give him a chance. I will take full responsibility.
Very well. It's your show. I just got word. Romania was a dead end.
You're saying that he lied?
Place is real enough. Deserted. But we found no trace that your man was ever there. Or anyone else, for that matter.
Someone erased his steps.
We'll keep digging, of course. But frankly, it's as if the Earth just spat him out. Are you still determined?
Does it matter? I was told there'd be no second chances.
Don't believe everything you hear, Miss Burnwood.
My decision stands.
Very well. I'll be watching. I hope you know what you just did. The chopper leaves at dawn. Now get out of my sight.
So what happens now?
You go back into the world. Disappear. Stay on your own and on the move. When we need you, we will contact you.
And so does.
He played his hand, and he lost. He cannot touch us now. Still, I can't believe we beat him at his own game.
If you know your enemy.
Quite right. I should tell you, the trail went dead after Romania. Our team found no records of any kind. No name. Nothing.
I think they called me 47.
That's not a name.
So make it one.
All right. Agent 47.
close. You define the art, and it defines you. Your actions have changed the world. Powerful men have fallen by your hand, but by the same token, others have risen. Do you realize what kind of world you've been shaping? Does the ICA? Does your handler? I live in that world. I have seen the consequences. I have felt the cost. That's what defines me.
How was Moscow?
Kamarov is gone. I set him up as a Langley spy. It's quite the scandal at the FSB. His death will not be investigated. Your turn.
Very well. The secrets of the global elite. 5 years of work. Everything we've collected. This thing makes WikiLeaks look like a gossip rag. The pen beats the sword, huh?
I have found that whoever wields the sword decides who holds the pen. Smile, Victor. Your reputation is safe. Now run along. I'm sure you have pretty dresses to attend to. Victor, good luck with the show. I have a feeling it's going to be the one you'll be remembered for.
Ether Security's in the dark about the incident. I feared the company knew about the virus, not even the board. Must have been someone at the lab. I understand. I'll get to the bottom of this.
Boss is unhappy. I followed you from Italy. I guess when you're invisible, you stop looking over your shoulder.
You did this.
Iago exposed you. ICA did the heavy lifting. I just pulled some strings.
Yeah, you're mine. How do you expect...
I play dirty. That's how you defeat a stronger opponent. You strike from behind. Now give me the key.
You have a family? Trust me, if there's a weakness, Providence will find it.
Take my chances. The key.
Fine. Won't do you much good.
It's funny. Cobb said the same thing. Thank you, messenger.
Don't. I just killed you.
Then we're even.
Compromised, but I don't understand. There is no sign of forced entry, no alarms, nothing.
One of my people has gone missing in Johannesburg. A key bearer.
I wish I'd been informed. Still, The system demands two keys, and the rest are all accounted for.
Except for your late predecessors.
Cobb? But his plane went down over the Pacific. It was an accident.
Such was the conclusion at the time. Yes. People die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. It seems like a conspiracy. Probably isn't. And yet, the failed coup in Morocco. Someone knows about us. There was a pattern and I failed to see it. Providence is under attack.
How much was there?
Money? Not money, Mr. Fannin. Information on all of our assets and operatives, like you. Dig a trench, Director, and make it a deep one, because none of you are safe anymore.
Stripped clean within hours of the kidnapping. Someone wanted the son dead to lure out the father. Someone smart enough to stay in the shadows while we did the wet work and the Highmores picked up the check.
A shadow client. Someone got rich. The contract was just. That was a sound problem.
I know you don't care about politics, 47. But ICA is neutral, or as has been. Can't allow ourselves to be manipulated. Besides...
It's happened before.
Italy. Morocco. Paris. All our clients got their intel the same way. Anonymous tips from a hidden source. Each contract perfectly legit, yet part of a grander design.
See the pattern.
Somebody does. The board has asked us to chase down this shadow client, and our analysts are closing in as we speak.
I know that tone.
Someone's playing a game, 47. The question is, against whom? Thickens.
Someone left in a hurry.
Sean Rose was not the shadow client. That much is clear. Whoever commands the militia, they got out just in time. Look around, 47. We're getting closer.
Some kind of network. Power players. From all sectors.
Familiar faces, too. Thomas Cross. Klaus Strandberg. Ether. And that's missing banker Eugene Cobb. Well, well.
There's a name. Providence.
What? No. No, it can't be.
The Hidden Hand. Thought they were a myth.
A hypothesis, nothing more. The idea that a small cabal of kingmakers, controlling enough corporate and political leaders, could effectively run the world in secret.
Maybe not so hypothetical.
Keep looking, 47. We need full disclosure.
Someone's done their homework.
Look how far it dates back. Hayamoto, Beldingford, Delvade. The Shadow Client has been tracking you for decades.
Now, how is that possible?
It isn't. Every one of those missions were branded as unsolved or accidents. He must have been looking for a pattern, a certain M.O., which would mean...
He knows me.
Well, at least this shortens the list.
Found something.
Sodas? But that would mean... Providence has infiltrated ICA, and Eric Sodas is their operative. Bastard! It all fits. He was the one who persuaded the rest of the ICA board to greenlight this operation. This changes everything. Get out, 47. We got what we came for.
What about the Shadow Client?
He is no longer our primary concern. ICA has been compromised. I always wondered if Providence was real, but I never actually... I will need to confer with the board, but mark my words, 47. This will have consequences.
Sir, you're trespassing. Stop moving now.
You'll follow me?
Hey, sir, what the hell are you doing?
Don't move. Stand still. Do not move a muscle.
Don't you understand what I'm saying? Put your hands up. Hey!
Rose is gone.
It was me, wasn't it? They tracked me. I don't believe it. I took every precaution.
Rose knew the risks. They all do. You did well, Olivia. I am proud of you. Now listen. The ICA knows about you. They kept you alive because they needed you, and now they don't. We won't talk again. Not until the storm is over.
I don't like it. This man, you know what he's capable of. You need to end this now.
I ran away as a boy. My friend and I. Away from that place. We came upon a small farming community. The people were dirt poor, but this woman, she took us in. We were awakened the next morning by the shots. A dozen people lay face down in the snow. A warden didn't like to leave witnesses. They shot the woman and her family last. They made sure that we watched the whole thing. This is your gift, the warden told us. Your gift and your curse. Touching lives. Only by ending them.
You know him.
Better than anyone.
Miss Burnwood.
That's not what my ticket says.
We received your message. Loud and clear, I might add. Honestly, you could have just sacked the poor guy.
I didn't catch your name.
No, you didn't. There'll be no retaliation, not for Soders, nor any other recent fiascos. Someone's been meddling in our affairs, killing our operatives, and making the ICE look like fools. I think you got close to that someone. Closer than we've ever been. That's why we're hiring you to take him down.
I don't think so.
Don't rattle our cages, Miss Burnwood. You really have no idea.
You spy on us, bribe our people, and you have the gall to demand our help. No. You can't be trusted.
Even so, we've been around for a long, long time. I think we could help each other. Some 20 years ago, your agency took in a young man with no past and extraordinary skills. In his own special way, he cares about you, and vice versa. And ever since that time, you've never stopped wondering where he came from and who made him what he is.
There was a doctor. Some depraved experiment. But he's gone now.
Ah. Well, if you believe the questions died with him, we have nothing further to discuss. If not, as I said, I think we could help each other. Partners, then. Cheer up, Miss Burnwood. We are the lesser evil. This terrorist. He wants nothing but chaos.
He's only a terrorist if you win.
Miss Burnwood, we won a long time ago. This is maintenance.
Has given us carte blanche. Hunt down the militia by any means necessary.
A week ago, Providence was a threat. How did you swing the board?
The board are practical people, 47. A blank check is hard to turn down. Besides, the Shadow Client's war on Providence is causing a global panic. Someone will need to stop the militia. Might as well be us.
And the man on the train? You never told them about his offer.
Taking a contract for personal gain is against ICA regulations.
Soders would have been proud.
Is that a sense of humor, 47? Whatever next? Crying at the movies?
Why are you doing this?
I know what it's like to have everything taken from you.
He claims to know about your past. Your childhood, your memories, everything Ortmeier stole from you.
And you trust him?
About as far as I can throw him. But this is our best lead in 20 years. I say it's time we break a few rules.
Berlin. Shanghai. Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
And you ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadow boxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray, the late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on, but before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Ah, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this Hearts and Flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
This is his fight too, Olivia.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Just get me inside. Rico, I need a favor.
Successful. Tactical targets neutralized. Militia transport network disabled. Location of primary target unknown. Team chasing several leads. End message. Encrypt and send.
Checks out. We can prove the board knew about the chemical leaks. We'll have grounds for a retrial.
It won't make a difference. They're too powerful.
They're not the devil, Nancy. Just a company. They're not above the law, don't you see? This is bigger than James. Those bastards killed 80 people.
And they got away with it. Think about what that means.
No one's untouchable.
No one's untouchable.
Diana!
Coming!
Diana!
got what we came for. Move out.
When the estate was overtaken by an obscure Soviet research fund, the Institute for Human Betterment.
Looks deserted.
The place was abandoned after a fire in 89. Then, only a few weeks ago, it was acquired by an anonymous investor using cryptocurrency. It has to be Lucas Gray.
He's here.
Be careful, 47. The breadcrumbs were almost too easy to follow. It could be a trap.
Not a trap. An invitation.
You came home. I knew you. You've come a long way, 47. And even now, you don't remember.
This place.
This was our prison, where Father trained us, shaped us into killers for Providence. You don't remember. They ripped it out of you, wiped it away, but I do. I remember everything.
You're a terrorist with nothing to lose. You'd say anything.
I know it's difficult. You never miss your mark or question your function, but we made a pact. You and I. Do this. We both lose.
There was an incident. That boy, he died.
He lived. Because of you. Don't you remember his name? You know this. Deep down, you know. What was his name?
Subject 6. Your name is Subject 6.
And what is our purpose?
To take them all down.
Sure that Ortmeier's children would never challenge them again. I'm the only one who got away unchanged. The only one left who remembers.
Ortmeier was Providence.
Everything he did to us, everything he made us do, it all leads back to them.
I'm breaking more rules than I care to count, Mr. Gray. What's your play?
The partners hide behind a cloak of anonymity. Only one man knows their true identities. Your client, the top controller, the one they call the Constant. He is the key.
But he is untraceable. So what am I missing?
A man would come to the Institute. A man with a Providence pin. The first constant. If we find him, if he's still alive, he's our way in.
You don't know who he is, but 47 does. That's what this reunion is all about.
Show them.
You're just gonna hand it over. Our one bargaining chip.
Olivia.
Fine. 47's memory was erased, irreversibly at the time. But after Ortmeier's death, his estate was acquired by the Aether Corporation. And they made an antidote.
It's a long shot, I know.
This is not how it works. We don't just join the revolution. ICA is neutral. We don't take sides.
I hate to break it to you, lady, but neutrality is a side. It's the side of the status quo.
People have died. Civilians. You align yourself with terrorists. Murderers.
Sometimes even monsters serve a purpose.
Look.
Enough. You have a choice. But I made mine a long time ago. I will finish what I started.
Subject 47, most gifted of all my boys.
So you're the pick of the litter. Tell me about the incident.
The subject ran away. He and another boy. The instigator was punished accordingly.
As were all the neighbors.
My men did what needed to be done. It won't happen again. Bring your house in order, Doctor. You won't like the alternative.
I remember who he is.
James. There will be no warning shots.
Cold War Spymaster and the first Providence Constant.
Last warning.
I wonder how much he remembers. The Ark Society. One of Providence's more obscure outfits.
I've heard whispers. A survivalist club for the global elite. Billionaires preparing for a global collapse. And now we know the Constant will attend their next gathering. So where is it?
That's the catch. The report is redacted. No names, no location.
So it's a dead end. I can't track them, not without ICA backup.
Now, I'm no big shot analyst, but it seems to me Janus was the Ark Society's founder, so chances are they'll want to pay their respects. In private.
Track the coffin. Worth a shot.
You're right.
It comes back in flashes. Fear, anger, but like it happened to someone else.
Your gift and your curse. What they did to you. Well, I spent a long time feeling guilty about that. Now, I wonder who got the better deal.
Yes! Found something.
What are we looking at?
The ass end of nowhere. But this is where Janus' remains were shipped to. Our choice for a final resting place, wouldn't you say?
Not bad. So we stake it out. Await the next gathering. Then we waltz in and kidnap one of the world's most powerful men. Without ICA backup.
Like I said, it's a long shot.
No!
We'll take it.
How did you not see this coming? My God, we came this close. The old man could have buried us all, our families.
Do you think you feel more betrayed than I do? Get some perspective, please. Janus is dead. Lucas Gray is about to join him.
And a cornered animal is twice as dangerous.
Let's be perfectly clear. We were not exposed. The threat is neutralized. We are back on track.
Even so, from this point on, we expect you to take...
No. There is no way I'm doing that. How can you question my loyalty?
In case treachery is contagious.
Do you really want to do this to me?
Is there a problem, Secretary?
No problem whatsoever, madam. Here's to loyalty.
My man on the island confirms that the Constant has arrived. We head out at sundown. Here, in case the crew get ideas.
Why are you doing this, Mr. Gray? You had a chance to walk away. Why didn't you?
A year ago, I'm working security for this banker, Cobb, only to find out he's a Providence operative. I've been running for decades, only to wind up where I started. We've all got barcodes on the back of our heads. Most people just never notice. 47 told me about your parents. How did they die?
Car bomb. Surrey, 1989. Company named Blue Seed didn't care to pay for the mistakes. But I like to think no one's untouchable.
I'm sorry for your loss.
You feel it, don't you? Unlike him, you feel it all. Everything you've done.
It's a dangerous thing, having a conscience.
Mr. Edwards, still think this is maintenance?
Oh, Miss Burnwood, what have you done? Changing horses midstream? Truly unprofessional.
You know what we want.
Where is the carrot?
No carrot. You're useless to the partners. Compromised. Even if we let you live, you can never return. Why die protecting them?
When I can drag them down with me.
It's a bad hand, but it's all you've got.
Three families. That's all it took. The Ingrams, the Carlyles. The Stuyvesants. Three dynasties secretly pooling their resources over generations, creating a singularity so dense that nothing escapes its gravity.
Never heard of them.
Well, they've heard of you. In fact, you just became the top of their agenda.
Go. We can't give them time to retaliate.
Don't take your eyes off him.
Be careful.
Well, here we are again. I must admit, I am disappointed, Miss Burnwood. I had such big plans for you.
Save it. I know the truth now. You're outplayed. You have nothing left to bargain with.
You're so certain. So sure of the people closest to you. He never fails, does he? He never misses his mark. You found a window into his past. And yet, something else remains hidden. A simple truth you learned long ago.
Diana!
Coming!
No one, Miss Burnwood, is untouchable.
Ivory towers are about to fall.
And when we're done?
Let's cross that bridge when we get to it. For now, the partners are all that matter.
There's an issue.
Of course there is.
Olivia's tracked the names mentioned by the Constant, and they're dead ends.
How dead?
Obituaries for all three have appeared online. Accidental death, heart failure, lung cancer.
They're covering their tracks. Faster than I thought.
A contingency plan of sorts. The Constant wasn't aware of it.
Well, seems they didn't tell him everything after all.
Something this big will leave traces behind.
The Constant says to follow the money.
Milton Fitzpatrick. The investment bank. It's a key Providence asset.
Which you worked for.
The director of the New York branch is a Providence operative. It's our best bet as a way in.
I'll tell the pilot to turn the plane around.
Right, gentlemen. Here's what we've come up with. The partners are transitioning between identities. But everything is so recent, the Milton Fitzpatrick bank records will still be intact. We've confirmed that the partners have active accounts there. However, the bank's records are remotely updated on a frequent basis. We may only have hours before any leads that could get us the new identities of the partners are gone forever. The data we need can be obtained in two ways. The bank's data core can be accessed through the basement vault, but getting inside the vault could be challenging. Alternatively, Bank Director Athena Savalas, Head of Security Mateo Perez, and Head of Accounts Fabian Mann each carry a partial backup drive with the data. We'll need all three drives to get the full data. Now, we cannot risk the partners discovering the data breach. Eliminating the bank's director, Athena Savalas, would sever the last remaining Providence tie to the bank and keep our activities hidden.
Okay, one more time. We break into the vault, extract the hard drive rack, and eliminate the director on the way out.
We.
You. Good luck, 47.
So, this is paradise.
If you can afford.
Gentlemen, glad to hear you made it out of New York. Where are we?
Olivia decrypted the data 47 recovered from the bank. We isolated three transactions from Providence partner accounts. All made out to Haven, a small corporation operating out of the Maldives.
And what does Haven do?
To the public, they specialize in reputation management for the rich and famous. The real money, however, comes from the covert reconstruction of identities for wealthy criminals. They make people disappear.
The partners are using Haven to acquire new identities.
Yes. Olivia's been attempting to hack the Haven servers, but the owners of Haven are manually resetting the access keys every 10 hours. That, unfortunately, makes them targets.
Haven Island is a true tropical paradise. Owned by the company's founder, Tyson Williams, the island is used by Haven as a combined headquarters and client entertainment center. Current and potential clients are ferried to the island and treated to the very best the Maldives have to offer. Michelin star chefs, a full massage spa, private huts, exercise facilities, and all the comforts of a luxury island resort are made available to them. 47. We'll be sending you in as a potential new client. We've put together a convincing cover story. You're Mr. Reaper, a thief for hire, looking to disappear for a while. Your mission on the island is simple. You need to eliminate the three owners of Haven. Tyson Williams, founder and rumored tyrannical CEO of Haven. Ludmilla Vitrova, a former confidence artist hired by Williams to serve as a client recruiter and handler. And Stephen Bradley, technical wizard and the brains behind Haven's proprietary software platform. So, that's Stephen Bradley taken care of.
With the owners gone, Olivia will be able to penetrate the Haven servers long enough for her to secure the new partner identities.
I've uploaded all the information we have on the island and the three targets. Best of luck, gentlemen.
I don't rely on luck.
Well, a little wouldn't hurt. Look closer. In the shadows. Behind the everyday world. Beyond the headlines and the seats of power, a hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable. The unforgivable, and it never gave us a second thought until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learnt the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base. Alexa Carlisle's helicopter just took off. Confirm target locations. Over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlisle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free, and since then he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlyle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth-generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War, and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, so Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
What's this? Carl, did you do that?
I certainly did not. I have no idea what's going on. Gentlemen, what's the meaning of this?
You. You're the one responsible for all this. Gray, what do you want?
Something that has been a long time due. Revenge.
Revenge? How banal. You killed Cobb, Navikov, Caruso, the Washington twins, everyone at Haven. You broke into our bank, and you outed Providence to the world. Whatever perceived slight we've done to you is insignificant to the amount of damage you've caused us. You've caused the world.
You're a murderous terrorist. Nothing more. What did we ever do to you anyway?
You specifically? Nothing. Providence, everything. Providence made me. And at the flick of a pen, Providence broke me. I'm just returning the favor. Providence has ruined the lives of countless people, expecting and facing no consequence for its actions. You take for yourselves and those who support you, and you burn everyone and everything else to the ground from the comfort of the shadows. No more.
You're delusional. Exposing us achieved nothing beyond moving a few pieces around on a board much more complicated than you can fathom. The world believes you're dead. What more do you want?
Me? Nothing. My friend, however, well, let's just say he's a bit of an expert. I'm just here to watch you die. 47. Finish it.
47. Finish it. Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Providence will soon be no more than a bad memory. 47. Thank you.
If that's your winning face, I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the Constant.
Nah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once, we can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did,
she'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlyle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this. All of it.
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.
She came home.
Carlyle's lost an empire. You fall hard enough, you tend to be reminded of what truly matters. So, the end of the line. You ready for this?
Are you? Who will you be without a score to settle?
I guess the world's most wanted fugitive will have to do.
Alexa Carlyle is dead, according to the funeral invitation, that is. So naturally, it caused quite a stir when the late matriarch turned up at the breakfast table, alive and kicking. Carlyle, wisely sensing that her number is up, has emerged from exile to tie up loose ends and secure the Carlyle legacy. She may be a monster, but you have to admire her due diligence. Carlyle descends from an ancient line of warrior aristocrats. Her great-grandfather made a killing in the Second Opium War and established an empire in shipping, railroads, and newspaper publishing. While largely unknown to the public, the family still asserts its quiet dominance over global transport and logistics, media, and technology. Most senior of the partners, Alexa Carlyle, is cold as ice, tough as nails, and sharp as a razor. Incidentally, it was her late father who first brought the three families together after the end of World War II at this very house, meaning that this gentleman is the birthplace of Providence.
It began here, and it ends here. Talk about poetic.
There's been a death at Thornbridge Manor. An apparent suicide. The door locked from the inside. But this was a murder. The family has a dark past. The manor is full of old secrets. Any one of them could be the killer. Our target has hired the best detective of our generation to solve the crime. An excellent opportunity to get close. Don't you think, 47?
So, Mr. Whitmer, you've reached a conclusion. Take a seat. Please, go ahead.
Your brother committed suicide.
I need to see some evidence to believe that, Mr. Whitmer.
Zachary was found dead in a room locked from the inside. He died from a rare poisonous plant he cultivated himself. He believed you were dead. And a suicide note explained that he did not have the courage to go on without you.
That's what I don't buy. I cared for him deeply, but the truth is he hated my guts. My death would not make him commit suicide, I can promise you that.
Perhaps the death of your older brother, Montgomery, then. I have found evidence showing that you and Zachary killed him nearly 50 years ago. I believe that was when Zachary turned recluse. Your brother recently uncovered proof that your past deeds were for nothing. A letter from Montgomery stating that he wanted you, Madame Carlyle, to take over from your father instead of himself, as you were better suited to the job. Everything would have turned out the way you wanted, without anyone dying. What broke Zachary once, now destroyed him.
And you saw this letter?
I did.
Oh, Zachary.
How royally I fucked up. Mr. Whitmer, I'm sorry. I just need to gather my thoughts. Right. The payment for your services, have you decided on an amount?
Arthur Edwards. You have a file on him.
Arthur Edwards? How do you... I see. Well played. For many, many years, I feared what I'd see when I finally met death. And now you sit before me, and I feel only peace. You see, I believe life is a fair fight, and I lost spectacularly in every way imaginable. It is time for me to leave the pit. Oh, before I get to that, your reward. The file you want is in the safe. A last wish from a dying woman. Get Edwards and make him suffer. So long. I need some privacy. Thank you.
Good work, 47. That's the file on Arthur Edwards secured. Time to take care of Madame Carlyle.
Mission complete. Well done, 47.
Stay down. Boss wants you alive.
Yeah?
How about now? Over here! Cover me! Walk away!
Or what? You gonna take us all on?
Don't.
Tell the Constant to start running!
You think you've won? 47 is out there. And 47 never misses his mark.
Neither do you, Miss Burnwood. That's what makes you valuable.
You're delusional. You think I would betray 47?
Trust me. You owe him nothing.
What is this?
I told you we could help each other, and I meant it. I look forward to your call.
Gray is gone. Go to Berlin and stay out of sight. We're all that's left now.
have been compromised. Abort and walk away now.
Who?
ICA. They tracked me. Don't know how.
It's what they do. How many?
One prime asset and a whole pack of up-and-comers. They've infiltrated the club searching for us. Christ, I think I killed one of them. Get out now before they spot you.
No. They found us once. They'll find us again. Keep your head down. I'll take care of this.
Good. Now let's talk business.
Well, talk.
I forgot that you're a man of few words. 47. I'm Agent Montgomery. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. You are a legend.
Legends die. I'm alive.
Well, not for long. Your friend Gray is certainly dead. Heard he begged for his life like a little baby lamb, ready for the slaughter. And to make things worse, you are now a liability to ICA. I'm curious. What happened to you?
The ICA has been compromised.
You, of all people, should know it's not our job to ask questions. We just do what we're told. ICA are incapable of being compromised. It's not part of their business plan. Well, anyway, it is truly an honor to finally meet you. Okay, that's enough talk. And don't take this personally. I have to admit, though, it's an even greater honor to be the one who took out the legendary 47. Because now it's time to die.
You should see the other guy. Never killed nobody before. What you did back there. You really are all Gray said you'd be. 47. He didn't suffer, did he?
Walk away!
He made it count.
But not broken. I'm glad. It's time we start afresh, you and me.
Get to the point.
You and your friends pulled off the impossible.
You stormed the heavens, took down the untouchables,
and yet, here we are. Status quo.
It just goes to show, you can't fight power, Miss Burnwood.
Power never dies, it only changes hands. The best you can do is
claim it.
I never cared about power.
Power is a tool, Miss Burnwood.
It's the thing that gets you to the thing. As the next constant, you can be the agent of change.
Transform the system from the inside, or be transformed by it.
No risk, no reward. I'll need to think about it.
No, you won't. The real question is, what will you bring to the table?
Look closer.
I'm telling you, the file is trash. The Constant doesn't so much burn his bridges as blow them up. Arthur Edwards, whoever he was, don't exist anymore. His personal data somehow deletes itself from any system that records him. Way beyond advanced. The partners spared no expense to make sure their controller would be untraceable.
How untraceable?
Look, I did what you asked, but Gray's gone and I'm no Diana. I'm not who you need right now. You gotta be kidding me.
ICA?
I used every encryption known to man. Who are these guys?
The best. It's only a matter of time before they get lucky. We need to take them down.
You and which army?
I know where the agency stores its files, mission reports, client data. If we leak it to the public...
You want to whistleblow the ICA?
It's the path of least resistance. Turns out, you are who I need right now, Olivia.
I do this, and I'm out.
We turn now to the data leak bombshell causing shockwaves across the world. The so-called ICA files. The disclosure of a...
You win. So,
what happens now?
The ball's in your court, Miss Burnwood. I do have other candidates, you know. Most of whom have never tied me to a chair.
You've seen the news. That was 47 acting on his own. He is untethered. He is unstoppable. And he cannot be bargained with. He will find you, Mr. Edwards. And I'm the only chance you've got.
I'm listening.
47 has one weakness. Me.
I found something. Buenos Aires International Airport this morning. Now watch this.
Heralds.
Trail ends at the airport. But, turns out that a top Providence operative owns a vineyard in the area. Don Yates, of infamous New York law firm Morgan Yates & Cohn. And get this, toasting his retirement party today.
She's infiltrated them. She's sending a message. She needs my help.
Could have fooled me.
You don't know her.
Anyway, if you're going after her, you'll need to deal with the Herald. Her name's Tamara Vidal, former CIA asset and political firebrand. She's a master of surveillance and the Constant's most trusted aide. She'll have eyes everywhere. You won't get far as long as she's in the game.
Why are you telling me this? I thought you were out.
Yeah. Old habits, I guess. Anyway, I need to go. See you around, 47.
No, you won't.
How did you know?
Your deal. That kind of power always comes with a price. What's yours?
I think you know. I am sorry. This is a necessary evil.
What have you done?
Ether Brand neurotoxin transfers by touch. See, Edwards learns by his mistakes, 47. And as you've clearly demonstrated, brute force is futile. It had to be me. It was the only way.
To get this close.
My family. I know what you did. After all these years, I finally know.
I am sorry.
You didn't have a choice. I did. Providence used you, but I'm no better. All I saw was a blank slate, a weapon to wield. I told myself it was what you needed, but people aren't meant to be controlled. This is a kindness. Goodbye, Agent.
Are you still here? Still clinging on to your self-image? Agent 47, the apex predator.
always hiding behind the headlines. Was perfection its own justification? Or a willful distraction? A wall built contract by contract to shield you from the uncomfortable truth. You're exactly the tool they bred you to be. Quite a piece of work you are. How could you possibly function on your own? You never even had a name. Until I gave you one.
That's him. Burnwood never ceases to surprise me. You really are a most singular individual. And to think, she wanted me to put you down. Lucky for you, I never throw away anything useful. Prepare the serum. Forgetting's not so bad. You've done it before.
What's he doing? Is he still looking at us?
I'm afraid so. Poor sap just won't accept his days are done.
Perhaps I should take him out to the woods and set him free.
Oh, it's a classic.
He was a loyal tool. But everything goes the way of the horse and cart eventually.
I couldn't agree more.
Are you done? The toxins are playing into your fears. Don't let them. Come on. Gotta get your head straight.
She wants me dead.
She has every right to after what we did. But that's not what is really going on.
She chose power. In the end, she was just like them.
No. She found a way to turn Edward's own cleverness against him. The rest is up to you.
I don't know how.
You do know.
Diana!
Coming!
Once you dispose of Edward's, I will dismantle Providence from the top down. It will finally be over. All you have to do is embrace the past.
What were we talking about?
Don't worry. We were done.
Thank you.
of resignations at the top level of international finance continues as Milton Fitzpatrick CEO Alexander Fannin joins the president of Hams and Oil, Juan Lee founder Tim Quinn, and plenty of others who step down.
It's been a long time, Agent 47.
That's not who I am anymore. The pact is done. The past, dead.
And yet, here you are.
I choose this path because I can. There will always be people like them. So there will always be people like us.
No one is untouchable.
It's good to be back.
For more than two decades, New York-based law firm Morgan, Yates & Cohn has been among the most successful and the most controversial companies in the United States. Founded in the greed is good downtown era of the mid-1980s by
Hey, asshole! What the hell is wrong with you? Go away!
Don't give him the satisfaction, Pam. He's clearly a jerk. Let's just go for a break.
Unbelievable.